Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Juan. I'm now an undergraduate for Imperial Valley College and currently working in the ER as an RN. And for today's video, we're going to be doing another reaction video, but now it's going to be to Nurse John. So let me see if I can show my screen. So Nurse John has been the one that I talked about in the previous video. But I never have gone into his Instagram, but I have seen on the Facebook, not on the YouTube shorts, the one of the ER to ICU given report. So I did want to do like some video reaction because I saw that it was like gold. So let's get right to it. Let's see which one do I want to see. This one. I only did like 8 weeks on OB and I hated every single moment of it. OB's not for me. It felt very uncomfortable, very awkward for both of us, for patient and myself, especially the husband was there. I did get the privilege to see a vaginal birth. When it happened, I was like, okay, whatever. I didn't really care. The only thing that I did find pretty moving was that the husband was crying. That was pretty nice. But other than that, never, ever, ever OB. No. Alright, let's see.
Hello everybody, I'm gonna be your therapist today. The goal of this therapy session is for all of us to heal, okay? Not to blame each other, but to heal. And we're gonna do a little icebreaker. So introduce your name, your specialty, and something that will describe you. Let's start with you, MedSurg. Hi, everyone. My name is Pamela. I'm a MedSurg nurse. And if there's something that's going to describe me, it's fuck around and find out. Hi, everyone. My name is Tina. I'm from the ER department. If there's something that's going to describe me, it's we're the best and fuck the rest. Hi, my name is Elizabeth. I'm from the ICU. And there's something that's going to describe me. It's intubated, sedated, with strain. Oh, my God, guys. That's an iceberg. Okay, let's try to be more calm, approachable, and like relax, guys, okay? Let's start unpacking traumas right now. Start with you, MedSurg. Alright, so one of the traumas I want to talk about is when departments brings in patient without notice. Ooh, period, purr. Bitch. Chill. Without a call. Okay, keep running your mouth, ED. Bitch. And when departments, you're talking to me? So when I take a patient because it doesn't pass their criteria. Thank you. Have mercy on us. Okay, I see you next. My trauma is ER and MedSurg. Because when you guys send us patient, you guys keep complaining you don't have time. But you guys seem to find time to break all your lines. Well, sorry, we don't got time because we don't have two patient max. Yes, please. Let's try to be a little bit nice. Hello, everybody. I'm going to be your therapist today.
The ICU of you only have two patients. Oh, damn. I don't know if there's like a therapy thing that they would do. I mean, I guess for legal reasons, you're supposed to at least have a psychologist or a counselor that you can talk to, right? Like it's a therapy, I guess. But, no comments.
Hey John, we're short staffed tonight, so it's just gonna be you and the CNA.
What the fuck is new?
Room number 5 should be playing with the kids in the bathroom.
Room number 6?
Room number 6 is a 67-year-old ceiling climber.
A what?
A ceiling climber. Yeah.
We got security, right? They're not fucking short staffed too.
They are, but okay. We got at least one.
It's not full moon today, everything's gonna be alright.
pants and pudding. Coming.
Hello?
Hi, I'm done pooping.
You're done pooping?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm coming. Oh, God. I'm gonna fucking pack you if you don't eat shit.
Pam, room 7 is complaining of chest pain.
What?
Chest pain.
Okay, everyone's finally asleep.
Pam, I think Mr. Smith is in the ceiling again. He left a note. He's gonna find the FBI.
Mrs. Smith, what the fuck are you doing in the ceiling?
The FBI is looking for me.
The FBI? They're down here.
It's not true.
Get your ass back here. It's 3 in the fucking morning. The FBI is waiting.
You're lying.
Okay, Elizabeth, let's change your...
Hey, John, we're short stop.
Hell no. I feel that's more like a MedSearch thing that would occur, but ER, nah, that's the last thing I would need. After that, no, no, no. Or restraint, screw it, but no. Oh.
Hello, is this ER? Okay, can you pass the phone to the nurse of Mr. Jones? Yeah, the patient will just left your unit without notice.
Without
Hello?
Notice?
Hello, ER, what the fuck is wrong? Are you the nurse of Mr. Jones? Huh? Are you trying to get beaten up and you're screaming for what? You're aggressive for what? Why are you sending patient without a notice? We're 200 over capacity. And the patient has to go somewhere, and I called you guys once, and you guys didn't answer. One call? Bitch, we're two people. There's 48 patients. That's your problem. I got two people punching each other. One of them is screaming. Don't even trauma dump at me, because if you want to talk about trauma, bitch, I got a whole day for you. Plus, you guys are complaining so much, you don't even know how it feels to be in hell. Bitch, I live in it. Anyways, I just want to let you know that the patient is actually on the way back to you. And don't worry, I didn't send him. He is sending himself down back there. You know why? Because you didn't even tell me that the patient is alert, but confused and disoriented times four. And you know what he did? He's
disoriented times four.
One of the ceilings on my patient's bathroom, so probably he's on the way back there. So if you hear a big kaboom, it's either the two security who's trying to find him or the patient himself. Okay, good luck.
Mr. Jones, you forgot your chart. Be safe now, okay?
What?
A chart? What the fuck? It's like a mental facility? Like, well, I mean, I guess. No, but maybe because it's in the hospital where I work in, where this does not occur. But I do fear that if I ever do work in San Diego or anything like that, this can occur. But I really hope not.
Hey, I see you. We're sending you one patient today. Have 2 seconds to give report. Whoa. ER. Okay. Chile. Aggressive. On top of it. I know. 67-year-old male. ABC. Antac. Whoa. Okay, Jimmy Fallon. You're gonna start head to toe. You're not giving me this crappy ass report. What head to toe? What the fuck is this? Nursing school? You want me to kick you from head to fucking toe? Oh, go on, Chicho. Listen, if I stay any longer than 2 seconds in here, you're gonna be doing my 2 admission, 3 discharge, you're gonna be looking for my 2 missing patients, one of them is in the ceiling, and you're gonna deal with my patient who's whipping everyone with his rectal tube. Read the chart. Did you say something? That's what I thought. Stay with your 2 patients. And also, I braided all your lines. You're welcome.
Stay with your 2 patients. Oh my god, that's so funny.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I'll know. I'll think of you every sip of my wine. But I wish you luck and no admission. But above all this, I wish you no cold blue. And I refuse this OT. Somebody else do it.
Damn. I wonder how Like, the management, well, I mean, I guess eventually, like, the workers, they do their best to kind of, like, balance all the chaos, but I really don't know, like, the management way of, like, being short-staffed, how that affects funding, how it affects the hospital for not shutting down, because you're not providing the best care to the patients, but I don't know how that will work out, because we're always short-staffed everywhere in the hospitals, throughout every single country, I believe. But, huh. But there was only like two occasions where I did stay a little longer, like 1 hour max, 1 hour and a half. But yeah, four, that's a lot.
Good morning and happy new year, everybody. Oh my God. Are you guys okay? Is there a new season of Walking Dead? Y'all look sick. Pam?
Damn. Yeah.
Are you sure you're good to give report, Pam? It looks like Kevin is calling you. Yeah, let's do this. Oh my God, girl, look at those dark circles. What have you been up to? So, room number one, we cannot find him. He's probably in the ceiling, but we don't know where in the ceiling. Room number two, decided to run naked the whole night, but she's sleeping now. Room number three, decided to punch room number four at 4 a.m. in the morning. Hold up, Pam. I actually got you a late Christmas gift, which I think you're gonna love. It is the new Pharmacy Wake Up Honey Eye Cream with vitamin C that helps target those dark circles, the sun bags you've been accumulating around your eyes, and also helps lessen those fine lines. All you have to do is apply it day and night around your eyes, and baby, it works like magic in minutes. And plus, it's 2023. We're focusing on self-care and self-love. So even though we look stressed and fatigued in the inside, we look flawless and fresh in the outside. Thanks, bestie, but, you know, I'm gonna need a bigger one, because this is not gonna be enough. Good morning!
I didn't know that was gonna be, like, a propaganda one, but it actually looks pretty solid, not gonna lie, the little cream, but damn, like, yeah, like, all the patients that I've seen here are, like, psych patients. I was like, what the hell are you doing here?
A 78-year-old dementia patient is restrained because the nurse is trying to prevent the patient from pulling off his IV that was being used to administer antibiotics. Instead of restraining the patient, what should have the nurse done differently? A. Ask the family member to monitor the patient's behavior. Dad, don't touch your IV. B. Give the patient sedative that will decrease their movement. Mr. Smith.
Maybe.
C. Stand guard over the patient until all the antibiotics were administered.
We're almost done here, Mr. Smith. Don't move.
Or D. Distract the patient and give oral antibiotics instead. But what would Nurse Sean do?
I'll do B. Screw it. All the peel?
A 78-year-old dementia patient is restrained
would
because
he's
trying to prevent the patient from pulling off his IV that was being used to administer antibiotics. Instead of restraining the patient, what should have the nurse done differently? A. Ask the family member to monitor the patient's behavior.
Dad, don't touch your IV.
B. Give the patient sedative that will decrease their movement.
Yeah, I remember, like, NCLEX always think about, like safety and, like, legal stuff. I would feel like real life would be B, but I guess maybe book wise T, maybe. Oh, Hyper Billy Ruby Nemia, something like that, no? I think that's one of the few things I learned from OB. Yeah, like their Billy Rubin gets really high and they turn yellow. Think. Don't quote me on it, but it will be another one that's cool for ER.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday,
damn.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday.
Damn. I only work 3 days a week, like 7 days, imagine? Shit. Oh shit. That was funny. Never had the chance for pitches to be playing their music, and then me throwing in the moves.
See you later. Bye.
You've been a great out today.
That's all right. Thank you. Bye.
See you later.
Bye.
That was funny. You told me you were a team player. It doesn't mean I need to stay 4 hours over. It's like, I'll be a team player for the 12 hours that I'm there. Oh my god.
You have nothing in life, but I gotta get rich. You can check and throw back, pick up in that bitch.
And I'll have you copy my structure, but put your tasks in.
True. I do mentalize myself before going in. And hope to God that we're not that short staff. But what else would be nice for ER?
Try not to be a cunt, it's Christmas. Take a tip from Santa's home. The rest of us are doing our best to be jolly. So don't go looking like you swallowed a bunch of holly.
That was funny. Don't be an ass on Christmas. Damn. How many people liked it? 46,000. I don't know if it's a thing, actually, like, they go home and they start drinking. Because imagine, like, having, like, that type of habit, I guess, every day you come from work. Damn. That's a lot of alcohol. Well, it depends. If it's just, like, a glass of wine, I don't think it matters, but whatever.
Merry Christmas, John. So we're short staffed tonight, so you're gonna have 10 patients instead of 6. Well,
it's 10? Beginning to look a lot like fuck this every single year.
Merry Christmas, Johnson. We're short staffed tonight, so you're gonna have 10 patients instead of.
Like, is that even legal? Like, I guess, like, the answer would be like, I don't know how that would play out, like, legal. Like, if something happens or something, like, would the hospital be at fault? Because, like, the nurse was not able to give the best care, but not because she was, like, bad with her time skills, but because, like, you know, she has more patients than what she needs to have. Like, if you normally have 6 patients, fuck. Dude, I barely have 4, and I'm, like, dying. Imagine 6, then 10. Fuck that. I'll be like, no, that shit's not legal. You're gonna give me 4, and that's it. But I don't know. I don't know how that will play out, honestly. So, like, I also want to get into management and be like, what the fuck? Like, how would you defend yourself in court? It's like, we're short staff, so can we screw up a little? Because we're, like, where our ratios are super, super, like, not balanced at all, which means our care is going to be affected. I don't know, but damn. No. You're broke. That would be like one thing that I was thinking, like, if you ever have the money to, like, if you won the lottery or something, like, would you still be a healthcare provider? I really feel like the big majority would be like, no, F this. So at the end, like, you're doing it because of the money, because you have no other alternative, in a sense. So that's like one really scary thing that I don't want to face in the future. Like, I don't want to be working in the hospital because I have to, because if I don't work, then I'm effed. You know, it's like, if I'm gonna go to work, it's because, like, I want to do it, and because I don't depend on this money to for me to be happy, because I already have these other things going on around me, which is giving me passive income. That's really what I would want to go to work, because imagine that type of mentality, like, I really don't need this, honestly, and I'm doing it because I really love it, not because of the money, because I have all these other things. Like, I really feel the work, your work input and output will be way different because you're not slave to it, in a sense. But that's just my way of thinking. But let me know what you guys think. So I was thinking, like, towards the end, like, how he was crying, I was like, I'm still pretty sensitive, so I'm like, I still don't have, like, that type of coldest heart.
So room number one decided to pull room number two's Foley catheter, so in defense, room number two punched room number one's hernia. Room number three, she's sailing on her pillow, she's supposed to find her cane, but I told her, like, her cane is the one she's using to row the pillow boat, but she doesn't want to believe me, so just let it be. Hi, so room number one is here for STI checking. Apparently they had an orgynization yesterday. Room number two, balls are so enlarged, apparently they were having a rough S and the girlfriend bit it, so we have to send this patient to the ER. Room number three, she's been cheating with her husband and just want to make sure that she's not pregnant. Hi, so room number one has 9 drips running. You can figure out because I cannot spend another 2 seconds in here. This afternoon, he pulled his rectal tube, drink from it, but now he's all cleaned up. And this also, before I left, he pulled up his Foley catheter and whipped me with it, but he's restrained now, okay? Hi, so room one needs Ativan. Room two needs Jesus. Room 3 needs to be retrieved from the ceiling. We don't know where he's at, but the police and the security is at it. Room 4 is preparing to leave because he's going to Mars to find the missing oxygen tank of this hospital. Room number 1 has successful vaginal birth. So the father is not the baby daddy, but the baby daddy's brother. Does it make sense? So room number 1 decided to...
I thought they were going to show, like, the ER or something. Damn. The one psychiatrist, like, he needs Jesus. That's really funny. Dude, same, honestly. Sometimes I just go to the restroom, I'm like, fuck. But it's like, just put on my AirPods real quick, just listen to a song, and come back at it. But yeah, sometimes it does get like that. Honestly, yeah, dude, like, nah. I would honestly bargain with them, like, I can help you. Like, if I did ever be in that situation where, like, I had, like, a certain days I really want PTO, I'll be like, look, I'll negotiate with you. I need these days off. I can work, like, not an extra shift, I'm probably, like, 4 or 5 hours, like, an extra day like that. So to work my 3 days, and then my fourth day work, like, half a shift or something, once every 2 weeks. So, you know, I'm helping out, but, like, hey, I need these days off. But, yeah. Damn.
Hey, nice to finally meet you. Sorry, I'm 20 minutes late. I had to do a report and we had a cold blue. Like, I'm so sorry again. Sorry. Reflex. You like some? You should. Before we get to know each other, I just have to do a quick neuro assessment. It's part of my protocol on a date, yeah? All you have to do is follow my pen light. Okay, pupils equal, reactive to light, accommodating, perfect. Just pinch my 2 fingers here. Equally strong. Okay, and push your feet with my feet. Oh, bilaterally equally strong. Period. Glasgow 15 out of 15. Any past medical history? Asthma. Okay. Do you know how you use your medications, right? You have your inhalers. Okay. Bronchodilators first, then corticosteroid. Yeah? And then you gargle your mouth after. Good. Do you have any allergies? Seafood? Yeah. What kind of reaction do you get? Anaphylactic reaction. Do you have your EpiPen? No. Red flag. It's okay though, don't worry about it. I have one in here. Just remember though, blue to the sky, orange to the thigh. Okay, you can keep it. So when was your last relationship? 7 months ago? Oh my god, I'm so sorry. If you're gonna rate the pain from 0 to 10, 0 being no pain at all and 10 being the worst pain ever, how would you rate the pain you've experienced in that relationship? Hey, nice to finally meet.
I don't know if, like, you as a nursing student or you as a nurse, doctor, EDA, whatever. You bring all your job into your dating life. I normally wouldn't unless they ask me about it, because like, who cares? Honestly, unless like you're with other healthcare providers there, but I mean, that's all you know, right? Eventually. But I don't know, I really wouldn't talk too much about my job unless they ask me about like a specific thing. But it's like, I really feel like people don't really care, so it's like, why would I? Yeah. No.
Hey, how are you? I really thought we're not gonna have a second date. Honestly, after that night, like, you didn't text me for like 2 weeks, so I was like, oh my god, maybe I scared him. Okay, so before I ask you how was your day, ask me how my day was.
Oh, yeah. No.
Shit. So we're gonna change our conversation a little bit. Like, this time it's gonna be more focused. Okay, so first question, when was your last bowel movement?
What does it matter?
Like, how would you describe it? It's like soft, hard, pebbly.
Why is it
family? Oh my god, you're constipated. Going back to history, any family history of like illnesses you might know? Yeah. Diabetes? One or two? One? Have you been checked? No? Like, how far is this in your family tree? Thank you, dinner is served. But before that, let me just check your blood glucose. This is just like a bite of an ant, okay? Okay, 6.4. You're fine. We're good. So, what's that? You have a massive headache? Oh my god. Let me check your blood pressure. Good thing I have my own blood pressure machine. Oh my god. Okay, so just give me your arm.
What the fuck?
Oh my god. Your veins. Oh my god, they're popping. Oh my god. Sorry, I like chunky veins. They're such an easy access and, you know, so attractive. Hey, how are you?
No comment.
When he talks, for fuck's sake, I'm having trouble talking to you, but I am smart.
True. Sometimes, like, I don't know why, like, I don't have, like, too much confidence in myself for whatever reason. And I need to, like, call the doctor for, like, some, to update on some stuff. And I'm like, oh, fuck. I'm like, shit. Like, there was one time that I had to, like, remove the phone. I was like, fuck, calm down, bitch. And it's like, and I was like, okay, sorry. What I was saying is, and then go from there. But, yeah. Last one. Let's see.
Hi, Aunt Lisa. I'm so sorry. I'm on my scrubs. I just finished a 12-hour shift. And this is a cake. It's a leftover cake my patient gave me today. But I promise it's really good. Do you know where's the wine bar? Hey, cousin Olivia. How are you? Yeah, I just have a question. Sorry, do you have anemia? Oh, it's your foundation. I'm so sorry. It's like Nana upstairs. Yeah? Okay, I'm just gonna come say hi to her. Hey, how's my favorite grandma? Good. Okay, so why are you staying in your bed? Like, if I fill up your rating scale right now, you're probably like 13 out of 15. Like, you're super high risk for pressure ulcer. Do you know that? Yeah? Okay, so do you want me to hold you or lift you down? Yeah? Grandma's looking a little different today. Hey, Grandma. Yeah, so I'm just gonna do a quick assessment. So, you're just gonna follow my instructions, okay? So, look at, like, follow the light. Okay, I'm just gonna go closer. Farther. Okay, you're gonna squeeze my finger. Hi, sorry everyone, sorry for bothering you all conversation. I just wanna like update you guys about the patient. I mean, grandma. Thing. Okay, don't be shocked. I think she's delirious. Like, I did my CAM assessment, my confusion assessment method, and she's like on the top. Like, I see granny's veins. They're so chunky. Like, my eyes has been like stuck on them. Like, do you guys mind if I like do a quick like IV insertion? It's just, Okay, everyone, I have a gift for everybody. It's not the most expensive thing, but I thought about it really a lot. So it's... Hi, Aunt Lisa!
The thing about the grandma showing delirious, that's pretty cool, not gonna lie. Because sometimes, like, you can spot those things as a healthcare provider. But, yeah, I mean... He has a lot of followers. 653,000, damn, that's a lot. Yeah, he looks like a really, really cool person. Very funny. Yeah, I'm going to keep on watching more on my own, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, I only watched like two of his, and they did not disappoint at all. So, yeah, I really hope you guys had a little bit of fun. I had his Instagram there at the beginning, so you guys can also follow him and like his videos and everything. So, yeah, I really hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please smash that like button. Follow me on Instagram if you haven't done so. And thank you so much, guys, for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.